This video is a quick overview and demonstration of the ServiceNow Mobile App Builder. Mobile App Builder is a creator tool that lets you configure ServiceNow's native iOS and Android mobile applications. It's a user-friendly development environment with the scalability and flexibility to support all mobile platform features. You can access Mobile App Builder directly in your instance in the System Mobile application. Here we can access the application scopes, as well as resources for learning more about Mobile App Builder and creating custom mobile cards. Clicking here gives us alternative access for learning options. First, we select the application scope where we want to work. You can work in any scope you have access to. The category Home screen shows which scope we're viewing and the option to return to the Mobile App Builder application scope page. On the left, the menu displays the most common categories to configure in the Mobile App Builder for the scope we selected. Screens is the default category. We can edit existing record types here, like the Launcher or Record screen, or we can create a new type. Other available categories are Mobile App Configurations, where you configure the layout, themes, and navigation bars of each ServiceNow app, Cards and Icons, which gives access to icons, card records, and card templates available for the scope, Functions, where you edit and change data, navigate between screens, or initiate actions on the phone, and Data, where you build data items to specify what information is displayed on the screen. The All Mobile Records category provides access to specific records in any table in the mobile platform table schema. When you select the table, all the applicable records are displayed. Now that we've seen the layout of Mobile App Builder, let's look at how to configure records. We'll start by selecting the Now Mobile app. Any configuration changes we make will affect only the selected app. The Now Platform Configuration tree starts with the mobile application we selected. This represents the highest level of the mobile platform application records. Each element in the configuration tree provides a visual reference to help navigate directly to any record we want to access. You can expand or collapse these records. This slider increases or decreases the size of the workspace. Here, the Mobile Interface Example panel is a visual representation of the fields we're editing and the record we selected. And in the center of the screen is the Configuration panel, where we view and edit the record. The fields available to configure depend on the specific record you select. We can immediately save all the changes we made, and then continue editing. Now that we're familiar with the layout of Mobile App Builder, let's use it to build something. For our example, we're going to add a list of coworkers, along with their contact information, in a card view on the welcome screen of our Now Mobile app. We want to place it between the top graphic and the section of icons below. After we confirm that we're editing the correct ServiceNow Mobile app, let's locate the Launcher tab record that holds our homepage launcher screen record. In the configuration tree, we can see the name of each record above the record type. Here we can view and edit the sections of the homepage launcher screen. The sections listed here relate the child records to this launcher screen record in the configuration tree. Selecting Choose next to the launcher section title shows us the UI section records we have access to. We want to create a new section, so we'll click New. For this record type, we have a few different options. We want to create a record section that will display a list of our coworkers, so let's select it. Now we see a new configuration panel, and our new record appears in the configuration tree. The color-coded indicators for our new record show that we have an unsaved change for our record, and we have a required field that hasn't been filled in yet. First, let's add a title. Next, let's create a new destination screen and give it a title. Now let's choose an icon, which is indicated here as a mandatory field. This is for a list of coworkers, so let's use an address book icon. As we fill in the required fields, the red indicator icons will disappear from the record tree. That lets us know we've fulfilled the minimum requirements for the record we're creating. Next, let's select and name a new screen segment. Then create a list stream and name it. This asterisk means data item is a mandatory field. So let's create one and give it a name. A table is required here, so let's select the user table. Next, we specify the conditions for our record. We have several choices here. We'll use the default option, declarative. This condition will make sure we have visible avatars for all our coworkers. And then we'll sort them by first name. Next, let's return to our list stream so that we can add our list item configuration. And here we select the same user table. This section requires a card, so let's choose one we've already created. And finally, we'll use an existing embedded screen. The last thing we need to do is put the launcher section we created between the two existing launcher sections. To do this, we go back to the home page launcher record and edit the order value here. Everything's done, so let's click Save. And success! All the required fields are filled and our records are saved, so we no longer see the indicators in our configuration tree. Now in our mobile app, the coworker list we created appears between the existing assets, just as we intended. This is just one example of how the mobile app builder facilitates fast, intuitive ServiceNow mobile applications for your organization. Give it a try and see what you can do. For more information, see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.